The Sisters of Providence in Terre Haute, Indiana, don't need anyone to tell them their founding mother is a saint. Mother Theodore Guérin arrived here from France in 1840 with nothing. Today, her followers pray, sing, and honor her legacy in a magnificent church she built. Out of the Indiana wilderness came schools, 8 of them, 3 orphanages, and an army of religious women who to this day care for the sick and the souls of all they can find. Sister Marie Kevin is one of those loving followers. And like many followers before her, she has been trying to officially make Mother Theodore Guérin a real Catholic saint.
She was a great builder of communities and of buildings.
That's right.
Of schools. You can tell by her letters she was a devout woman of God.
She was.
But sister, a saint?
Yeah.
But as you're about to find out, living like a saint, having followers who think you're a saint, and even performing miracles, well, like a saint, is not always enough to become one. There is the bureaucracy. There is money. Hundreds of thousands of dollars needed. And official church-approved representatives in Rome to push your cause, called postulators. The Sisters of Providence have been trying to do this since the turn of the last century.
A lot of church and world events slowed the process down. We appointed 9 different postulators between 1909 and 1994.
In the making of saints, number 10, Piazza de San Pietro, is where the real business takes place. No saint becomes one until his or her cause passes out of those doors. On the third floor here, a group of theologians work in secret, scrutinizing every document in a person's life to determine if they were truly holy. Then another mysterious council of historians, scientists, and doctors ask for something extraordinary.
We ask for a sign of God.
Father Peter Gumpel scrutinized hundreds of cases of saints in his nearly 50 years at the Vatican.
A miracle. Some extraordinary fact, especially in the medical field, a cure that nobody expected, and suddenly, against all the expectations, this person is cured.
And to become a saint, you need not one, but 2. Mother Theodore's meticulous notes and letters would become the basis for determining if she truly led a holy life, but what about the miracles? The first came in 1908. A nun suffering from a huge tumor prayed at the grave of Mother Theodore, not for herself, but for a friend, and awoke the next morning cured.
That sister who was healed was 48 years old when she was healed. She died when she was 86.
The story of the miraculous healing was kept almost a secret, but behind the scenes, supporters of Mother Guérin began to think they truly did have a saint in heaven. Donations began to flow in for the cause. Then the wars came and went, the money came and went, the sisters began to lose hope.
There were some people who did not want to proceed with the cause. They thought it was a little too dramatic, are a little too demanding of our time and efforts. But most of the sisters were very interested and desirous of it happening.
But with their case stalled, the Sisters of Providence needed their own miracle, somebody who could guide their cause through the bureaucracy of the Vatican. They found that person here on the Via Tormalina, not a priest, but a lawyer, so specialized in making saints, the Italian press has dubbed him the Saint Maker.
He just seemed to be so suited to this particular cause.
He is Dr. Andrea Ambrosi, a man connected to the causes of nearly 400 saints. When we met him outside St. Peter's Square, he told us through his assistant, Madeline, he was juggling the causes of 30 to 40 more.
Are they all saints?
Well, they're not saints yet.
Though his small walk-up office on Via Tormalini doesn't show it, Insiders say Andrea Ambrosi has become wealthy in the expensive pursuit of making saints.
So, saint maker is accurate.
Un fascitore di santi.
Yes, broadly speaking, it is.
Ambrosi says the cost is flexible depending on the wealth of the clients. American causes can be the most expensive. Starting at $40,000, cases can last for years and costs can add up to as much as $1 million. But despite the cost, he told the sisters they had a very good case. The saint maker, well, knows a saint when he sees one.
I must say, she was an extremely brave woman. She's a great example of a truly modern woman.
Dr. Ambrosi determined the only thing holding back sainthood for Mother Theodore Guerin was just another sign, another miracle.
We know the second one, yes.
When we come back...
You gotta turn the camera off.
Yes, this is gonna give guys nightmares, I tell you. That's about as good as it gets.
Could this Baptist be the answer?
Yeah, well.